Hello, my dear students. So today we are here to discuss topic circuit breaker. So we are basically going through introductory part in this lecture. So as you all know, circuit breaker is a very important element or a device in our power system production. So basically circuit breaker, so basically in this slide, or you can say that in this lecture, we are going to consider these topics. Then that is, what is need of the circuit breaker, where it is used and how it operates. So in this module of lecture, we are only going through this part, that is what is circuit breaker and in this and need of circuit breaker, types of circuit breaker, where it is used and how it operates, we consider in next module. First of all, we see where circuit breakers are basically used and where we have seen circuit breakers. So as all of you have done training at training center for nearest service stations, you have found this type of diagram. This is a single line diagram of a service station. So as you can see here, somewhere generation is done. Then that voltage is step up to 220 kV or something higher, then that is step down to 220 kV, then that 220 volt is further step down to 132 kV, and 132 kV is further step down to 33 kV, which is nearest substation to our houses. So as you can see, these are the feeders, or you can say buses. On both side of the incoming feeder or buses, you can see these devices. As you can see, these are the isolators. So these devices are isolator, and beside these isolator, this is a circuit breaker. So for protecting any devices, any either transformer, generator, we need circuit breaker. So as I have already told you, that isolators are no load switches, whereas circuit breaker are on load switches. So whenever any fault comes, so first circuit breaker trips, after that your isolator trips. So how it starts and how the process is going on, we can see in our next slides. So now this is basically a control room layout of 220 kV Nellore. So as same structure from previous, these are the incoming buses, 220 kV, then this is 132 kV, and this 132 kV is again converted to 33 kV. So as you can see that these are the devices which are in green color, as you can see, which are green color everywhere. So these are basically breakers, and these are the transformers. Then there is CVT, as you can see. So this and these are the lighting arrestors which are placed here, and these are basically isolators. So basically isolator is a type of circuit breaker, but it is an off load devices, and circuit breaker are on load devices. So basically there is a difference between circuit breaker and isolator, that circuit breaker works on load, but isolator work only when there is no load, means off load. So we have come to this topic, that what is circuit breaker. So as you can read, a circuit breaker is an automatically operated electrical switch designed to protect an electrical circuit from damage caused by overload or short circuit. You can also say that the device which makes or breaks the circuit can be called as circuit breaker. The functional operation of circuit breaker is similar to typical switch, but in the operation of circuit breaker, especially at the instant of breaking, certain unwanted phenomena called as arc is developing. So there is a large electromagnetic discharge associated with the performance of circuit breaker, thereby an elaborated study necessary in the functioning of circuit breaker compared to simple switches. So basically this is a circuit breaker layout, or you can say that this is a basically relay circuit layout. So as you can see, the line which has to be protected by circuit breaker is this. So let us consider this line has to be protected. Now as you can see, the current transformer is connected with its primary in series with the line to be protected. The secondary of CT is connected in series with the relay coil. As you can see, this is the relay coil. The relay contacts, these are the relay contacts, are part of the trip circuit of a circuit breaker. The trip circuit consists of a trip coil, battery, in addition to relay contact. The trip circuit can operate either on AC or DC. You can use whatever you want. Now consider, let us consider that some fault occurs. Here, some fault occurs. Now what happens? What happens? Then current through the line connected to this increases to a very high value. Now this current transformer senses this current. Now according to its secondary current increases, because here it is single bar and here it is multi-turn. So whatever the current is here the maximum value get increased. Now this secondary current increases, which is nothing but the current through relay coil. Thus the relay coil contact get closed mechanically because the current is very high and it attracted it. So the relay contact get closed mechanically under the influence of such high fault current. Thus the trip circuit of circuit breaker get closed circuit. This circuit completely gets closed and current start flowing from the battery through trip coil in a trip circuit. Thus the trip coil of a circuit breaker get energized. This activate the circuit breaker opening mechanism, making the circuit breaker open. This isolate the faulty prod from the system. So this is a basically working of a circuit breaker. So in the previous slides we have seen in the arc occurs in circuit breaker, which makes it different from other simple switches. So in this slide we are going to study how the arc formed and what happens when arc form and how it can be extinguished. So as you can see, this is our fixed contact and this is our moving contact, and here when they get separated, the arc formation occurs. So what happens under the occurrence of disturbance, the moving contact of circuit breaker gets separated from fixed contact due to the action of relay. So in this separation, the contact length between the two contact decreases and contact resistance of cause current density to increase in fixed contact. So fixed contact are associated with more electromagnetic energy. So at the instant of moving contact separated from fixed contact, by the last tip, a sudden open circuit is established. Thereby, all electromagnetic energy which is present here is converted into electrostatic energy, which increase the voltages, which increase the voltage to high value. This high voltage appearing across the two contacts will set up necessary potential gradient. Thereby, the space between the two contacts subjected to dielectric breakdown and dielectric breakdown occurs. So what happens when dielectric breakdown occurs? The gases which are present nearby this area get ionized, and ionization starts from fixed contact to moving contact. So when the discharge touches moving contact, a short circuit path is established through which heavy inrush of current take place. This is called as arc. So arc can be considered as column of ionized gases. So basically it is purely in resistive nature, means there is no reactive component. This arc carries large value of current and temperature, which may cause electrical or thermal breakdown. So we have to remove this arc, means we have to extinguish this arc as early as possible, because in power system microsecond time is also valued, so it has to be removed. So in next slide, we are going to see how it removed or how it can be extinguished. This is a basically a circuit diagram of circuit breaker. This can be considered as a fixed contact and this can be considered as moving contact. So by memorizing this circuit, you can see that this circuit you have studied in fundamental of electrical analysis. This is basically an AC source. This is an inductor and this is a capacitor. So basically here we have placed breaker by showing this, that what happened when the breaker gets open, then this circuit get so AC analysis of LC circuit. So as we already know that inductor absorb electromagnetic energy and capacitor absorb electrostatic energy. So what happens when this circuit activated, then all when this circuit breaker is open, then all electromagnetic energy which is absorbed by the inductor gets completely converted to electrostatic energy in the capacitor. So then this complete electrostatic energy, that is half CV square, cause the voltages very high value, and this air which is present nearby to the breaker get ionized and a short circuit path established. So that is the phenomena of arcing. So this can be understood by seeing the figure. As you can see, this is the voltages, system voltage. As you can see, this is an arc voltage and this is the current. So basically going through this circuit, we can consider it that when the system voltage LC circuit forms sinusoidal voltages and sinusoidal current. So basically this is a sinusoidal voltage and this part is showing some leading curve. So this is the system voltage, and when the current, at the instant when current gets zero, we can see that voltage is fluctuating and it then decreases to zero. At the instant of current zero, some doubling effect, as you can see, this spike goes to twice of EM, which can cause a very high voltage. So this has to be extinguished and removed. So this can be done using some phenomena which is we can see in next slide. Thank you. Basically, as we have seen, that arc which is formed in the analysis of circuit breaker has to be extinguished or has to be removed as early as possible. So there are some method which can be used to interrupt arc to form the short circuit path. The basically, you can see high resistance interruption and low resistance interruption are the two method which can be used. So basically what happens in high resistance method, in this method the resistance of arc is increased so that arc current decreases. The resistance of arc should be increased to such an extent such that the resulting current could not be able to sustain between the two contacts. Thereby arc is said to be extinguished, and that can be done using this method, that is cooling of arc, increasing the length of arc, reducing the cross-sectional area of arc, or splitting of arc. So basically all these methods are used to extinguish the arc in the formation of in the arc formation. Low resistance interruption is basically lesser used because high resistance interruption basically used because this is a simple method and these are very typical method. So basically we in this method there are two processes which can be done. In energy balance theory we are doing, if rate of heat of generation is greater than rate of heat of dissipation, then the arc is extinguished, because simply when the fixed contact and moving contact get separated, so what happens, the rate of generation of heat is greater and the dissipation is less, then the arc extinguishes. If the dissipation rate is high, means the gas which are ionized is very high, then what happens, the short circuit established. And in what happened in voltage theory, in this, if the dielectric strength increases more rapidly than the re-striking voltage, arc is extinguished. So as we have seen, when the fixed contact separated from moving contact, a re-striking voltage, that is twice of EM, gets. So if it increases rapidly as per the dielectric strength which is of air, so if it is increases, then arc extinguished. So basically these are the two methods which basically prefer. Also there is some methods which are current zero method, but it is basically preferred for only AC circuit breaker, because in those methods what we can do that in AC supply the current arc voltages crosses zero for every half cycle. So what happens, all the electromagnetic energy gets converted into electrostatic form, thereby voltage rises. So what happens in particular, that at the instant of zero voltages we are going to extinguish the arc, so which can cause the voltage. So basically thank you students. So we have come to end of this module. In the next module we are going to study about the types of circuit breaker and what are the basically types are and at which voltages which type of circuit breaker is basically preferred, and as you have all seen in the substations which circuit breaker are present and why they are used. So all these we can consider it in next module. Thank you.